Foreign keys are part of what makes a relational database relational by creating clear relationships between tables. But more importantly, foreign keys help us ensure that all of the data entering our database is consistent and valid. Let's take a look at an example database to illustrate what foreign keys are and how they're used. This fictional bookstore database has three tables: users, orders, and books. Each table has one column with a unique identifier. This is the primary key. Primary keys are kind of like ID numbers. In the same way an ID number identifies you uniquely, even if someone else has the same name as you or shares the same mailing address, a table's primary key allows the database to identify a unique row even if the other columns in that row don't have unique values. Every table in a SQL database must have a primary key. In our bookseller database, user ID, order number, and product SKU are the primary keys for the users, orders, and books tables, respectively. Now that we understand primary keys, let's talk about foreign keys. Take a closer look at the orders table. Each row is an order. Each order has an order number, a user ID that represents the user who placed that order, and a product SKU that represents the book they purchased. We can see that user ID and product SKU also correspond with the primary key columns in the users and books tables, respectively. But right now, that's just an informal relationship. They aren't connected in any meaningful way, they just happen to share the same data. We can formalize that connection and add some important rules at the same time by adding foreign keys. When we add foreign keys, we're establishing that the orders.userID column references users.userID and orders.productSKU references books.productSKU. But we're also doing something more important, creating rules that say a row can only be added to the orders table if its user ID value exists in the users table and its product SKU exists in the books table. In other words, with our new foreign key rules, we can only add a new order if its user really exists in the users table and the product SKU really exists in the books table. So foreign keys aren't just about linking tables together with clear relationships. They actually help us ensure that our data is accurate by rejecting insertions that don't make sense, like an order with no user attached or an order for a book that doesn't exist. One important rule for foreign keys is that the column in the table we're referencing must have only unique values. That's because when we create a foreign key for orders.userID, for example, we're linking each row in the orders table to a specific user. You may have noticed that both of the foreign keys we added to the orders table link to the primary keys in the other tables. It's good practice to make sure all of our foreign keys are referencing primary keys in other tables. In this video, we've covered a lot. We've talked about how foreign keys create links between tables and how they help ensure accuracy by only entering data with a valid connection to the table being referenced. Hit subscribe to make sure you don't miss an upcoming video on how to put all of this into action by adding foreign keys to your database tables with SQL.